Healthcare simulation plays a critical role in patient safety. It bridges the gap between classroom learning and real-life clinical experiences. It allows clinical skills to be learned through hands-on practice, and it also improves teamwork and communication.
Our pre-brief area offers a comfortable learning environment for our learners. Pre-briefing offers participants an orientation to the simulation suite and enables them to reach their intended learning objectives. Debrief is a period of time following a learning activity during which learners reflect and review their scenario in order to meet the learning objective of the session.
The SimMan 3G mannequin is operated by our trained staff from our control room. The control room is fitted with one-way glass window and a microphone to answer the phone calls and also to be the voice of the mannequins. This aids the realism of the simulation scenario. We are able to link the simulation suite to the lecture theatre. This enables a large number of candidates to be taught and make sessions more interactive.
Our state-of-the-art simulation suite can be altered to reflect any clinical area and hosts Lurdle's SimMan 3G. This is one of Lurdle's leading simulation mannequins and has a multitude of functions to aid learning. We also have within our simulation department Sim Junior, a 6-year-old child, Sim Baby, a 9-month-old baby, and the youngest version, Sim Newbie, which is a newborn baby. Our ILS mannequin can be taken to any clinical area to offer in situ simulation. This is simulation integrated into the clinical environment. It provides hands-on teaching for staff in their own clinical area and allows the session to be tailored to the area's clinical learning needs.
Simulation can be used by all members of the multidisciplinary team for a variety of training needs. At Royal Bournemouth Hospital, it benefits doctors, operation department practitioners, therapists, pharmacists, paramedics, midwives, nursing staff, healthcare assistants, and all the student groups.
Examples of some of the simulation we run are managing the deteriorating patient, the Dorset transfer course, stroke outreach training, safe sedation training, and the gas again anaesthetic training day.
We are always looking for simulation to be used in innovative ways, and we have some exciting projects planned for the future, such as human factors training, falls assessment training, pharmacy technician training, and verification of death training. Simulation training requires extensive planning and preparation to ensure that the sessions are effective. We involve experts within the particular clinical area to ensure that this is achieved. If you have a training need and feel simulation would be of benefit, we would love to hear from you. Please submit a training request form by the e-forms or email simulation.training@rbch.nhs.uk. To keep up to date with all things simulation related at RBCH, follow us on Twitter @RBCHSimulation.